Good evening. Welcome to the Conroe Independent School District mid-year graduation for the class of 2021. My name is Greg Colston, and I'm the Assistant Superintendent for High Schools. Tonight, we are celebrating the accomplishments of students in this very formal setting. On behalf of the class of 2021, we ask that the audience respect the dignity of this ceremony by refraining from using any outside noisemakers. Every one of these graduates deserve to have their name heard as they walk across this stage. At this time, please rise as we greet and honor the processional for the class of 2021. Can we turn on the house lights, please? Those would be the ones overhead. Okay, while we're waiting for that, please remain standing, and gentlemen, please remove your hats for the pledges to the American flag and Texas flags. Leading us in our pledges tonight will be Sophia Wall from the Woodlands High School.
My name is Sophia Wall from the Woodlands High School. Will you please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance and the Texas Pledge? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible. You may be seated.
Thank you, for Sophia, for helping us honor our nation and state as we begin our ceremony this evening. Please allow me to introduce our guests on stage this evening. I ask that you hold your applause until I finish introducing each group. From the Conroe Independent School District Board of Trustees, Mr. Skeeter Hubert, President. Mr. Scott Moore, First Vice President. Mrs. Teresa Wagaman, Second Vice President. Mrs. Stacy Chase, Assistant Secretary. And Mr. Datron Williams, immediate past president. From the Conroe Independent School District, District Administration, Dr. Curtis Null, Superintendent. Dr. Chris Hines, Deputy Superintendent. Dr. Shelley Winkler, Assistant Superintendent for Elementary Education. Dr. Bethany Medford, Assistant Superintendent for Middle Schools. And Mrs. Denise Cipolla, Coordinator of Guidance and Counseling. From our campus administrations, Dr. Rotasha Smith, Conroe High School Principal. Dr. Chris Povich, Grand Oaks High School Principal. Dr. A.J. Levecki, Oak Ridge High School Principal. Dr. Mark Merle, College Park High School Principal. And Dr. Ted Landry, the Woodlands High School Principal. Introducing our graduates this evening are from Conroe High School, Carrie Young, from College Park High School, Christina Flores, lead counselor. From Grand Oaks High School, Victoria Brinkman, associate principal. From Oak Ridge High School, Joe Hawk, lead counselor. And from the Woodlands High School, Stacy Mosley, associate principal. Also with us tonight who have helped with the ceremony are the following lead counselors: Kim Dwyer from the Woodlands High School, Karen Peary from Grand Oaks High School, and Lydia Joyner from Conroe High School. A special thank you to Grand Oaks High School for hosting our ceremony this evening. And finally, please welcome Ava Grace Newton from Grand Oaks High School, who will now deliver our student remarks.
faculty, administration, family, friends, and fellow graduates. It's truly the greatest privilege of my high school career to be standing here today and giving this speech. Everyone here has had a different experience of high school. Most of us are graduating from different schools, yet here we are together now. Personally, I came into Grand Oaks as the first full graduating class. But all of us here have had a roller coaster of the past few years that we have experienced together. When I think about our graduating class, the first thing that comes to mind is the uniqueness of our high school career. The group of students I'm speaking to did not let anything stall their journey. Some of us graduated a semester early and even took a summer school class, which took ambition and self-discipline. But all of us have worked hard to get here today and have cultivated a strong sense of self-motivation. As December graduating class of 2021, we traveled through the COVID-19 pandemic, having our ups and downs. This pandemic not only altered the lives of millions, but changed education on the global scale. The 2019-2020 school year, we went on spring break and literally never came back. We spent the rest of our year online and in quarantine, which really meant one easy assignment per week, if that. It sounds nice, but not really. I think we all saw the effect of that in our grades and gaps in our learning. But we learned how to adjust quickly. We learned how to pivot, navigate Canvas way too well, and be self-disciplined in all of our work. It was a change that we could all look back on and recognize that we learned, that we benefited by learning skills that will help us in our future endeavors. Online school seems easy and fun, but in reality, our 2020-21 school year absolutely killed us. We had to master keeping on top of our work, refrain from slacking, and grinding out to the last day of each marking period. It seems far-fetched now, but these skills are going to help all of us in the future. Our society has changed as well. We've had to adjust navigating through a polarized country with extreme opinions as we try and figure out our own. The exponential rise of social media and changes in our political administration has driven these viewpoints farther apart, only adding to the division. But as I talk about these major happenings in our world, I believe that it truly highlights how different our generation and in turn our graduating class is from others. Despite the disunity around us, our generation is the most inclusive yet. We are known to genuinely welcome those different from us and to take a stand for them. If you take a glance at those of us graduating today, we all encapsulate that. Each of us are very different. We have different backgrounds, experiences, and viewpoints on life. In fact, each of us has different reasons to graduate. Ironically, COVID was a big push for a lot of us, including myself, as we realized we don't know what will happen tomorrow. So take advantage of time, opportunities, and the moment. Therefore, the past years, the only consistency in our high school career has been change, and huge changes at that. But when you think about what will become of you, isn't change the only constant? Change will not be isolated to our time in high school. It will follow us through our careers, friendships, relationships, and much more. We simply got a taste of it in high school. However, as we stand here today, proud of what we've accomplished, I cannot help but feel as though we are a small part of huge events in history. When future students look back at the pandemic, they'll think of what it must have been like not to go to school for up to a year and a half. Maybe they'll remember masks being a part of our dress code, social distancing at lunch, or an option to leave SAT scores off college applications. I'm sure they'll find a way to romanticize it if they're anything like our generation. But to be able to say that you experienced 2018 through 2021 firsthand holds a unique power. It holds a power to help future students to have empathy for those who must adjust quickly, take hard lessons, and much more. I wanted to thank the administration and some very special teachers in my life, as this has been a really hard adjustment for y'all as well. Our world has changed in more ways than one, But through this, we gain life skills that provide us with an advantage to overcome what may seem difficult. It reminds me of a quote by Mary Shelley that some of you may recognize from our summer school study of Frankenstein. She says, "Beware, for I am fearless and therefore powerful." Although our high school experience has been quite unique, it hasn't been the easiest and it's come with our challenges. It definitely hasn't been ordinary. It's armed us with life skills that will serve us well in college and the future ahead, making us fearless and powerful in the face of change. Thank you.
Thank you, Ava Grace. Graduates, there are many people to acknowledge this evening who have played important roles in your lives. At this time, will the parents of our graduates please stand and be recognized? Without your continued support, this day would not be possible. Parents? We'd also like to acknowledge the many proud grandparents and great-grandparents who may be here with us this evening or could be watching on YouTube. If you're present with us this evening, grandparents, please stand and be recognized. In addition, I would like to thank our school representatives who have joined us, as well as the many teachers who have worked so hard to help our students arrive at this moment. Would all the teachers and staff, elementary through high school, please stand and be recognized. This time we'd like to pause and remember our troops serving our nation throughout the world. There are likely loved ones and family members who cannot be with us tonight because they are keeping us safe. We keep them in our thoughts. If you are active duty in the United States Armed Forces, a veteran from any of our armed services, or you are a graduate entering the United States military, please stand as we give you our thanks and appreciation for your time and dedication to our country. Will the class of 2021 please rise? President Hubert, members of the Conroe Independent School District Board of Trustees, and Dr. Null, Superintendent, it is my distinct honor and privilege to certify that these students from Conroe High School, Grand Oaks High School, Oak Ridge High School, the Woodlands College Park High School, and the Woodlands High School have met the requirements of the Conroe Independent School District in the state of Texas and are hereby entitled to be graduated from the Conroe Independent School District and their respective high schools with all rights and privileges appertaining thereto. Graduates, please come forward.
Jeff Johnson IV. Esmeralda Maya Romero. Juan Carlos Revelo Santos. Marcus Santero Scott II. Emily Coquise Smith. Natalia Milagro Uribe. Allison Michelle Vosick. Jennifer Desiree Webb. Takayla Renee Wheeler.
Victoria Nicole Romero. Ava Grace Newton.
Gianfranco Dalbo. Isabella Del Carmen Diaz. David Isaac Hirone. Nadia Quinn Ochoa. Derek Michael Russell Jr. Venice Ricardo Valencia.
Joshua Anthony Glaw. Cody Ryan Medenka. Maria Valentina Nava.
Ryan Scott Barnes. Leandro David Cabezas. Benjamin Kyle Easterling. Joshua David Fishman. Nathaniel Anthony Gorham. Julia Emma Mora. Jose Antonio Rosales Ramos. Madeline Olivia Lois Stanley. And our final graduate, Sophia Wall.
Graduates, congratulations on achieving this outstanding accomplishment. You have worked very hard, and I know you feel all of your hard work was well worth the effort. We wish you the best of luck. Graduates, if you would please stand. Please welcome Cody Medenka from College Park High School will lead the graduates with the turning of the tassels.
Like the countdown at midnight on New Year's Eve, the turning of the tassel represents the changing of time. Graduates, will you please stand with me? We pass to the next graduating class at our respective schools, the legacy of pride and persistence of the class of 2021 as we turn our tassels to the future. Please turn your tassel from right to left. Please join me now.
Thank you again. Congratulations, graduates. This concludes our ceremony. We wish you all safe travels home. Thank you.